Hi, my name is Yingchen Lin. I'm a graduate student in the Department of Horticultural Science at North Carolina State University. I'm preparing this video to give a brief introduction of blueberry breeding in North Carolina, which is related to my graduate research. Blueberries are one of the few crops that are native to North America. In taxonomy, blueberry belongs to the Ericaceae family and genus Vaccinium. Other common vaccinium crops include cranberry, bellberry, and lingonberry. Blueberry is the second most important small fruit in the United States, behind strawberry. North Carolina is one of the significant players in the United States blueberry industry. Just like other plants in the Ericaceae family, blueberry grows well on acidic, moist soils that are often conducive for successful production of other plants. There are four commercially important blueberry species. The highbush blueberry is the most common species grown in cultivation. The highbush blueberry can be further categorized as northern and southern highbush, depending on the region they grow. Most fresh blueberry found in the grocery store are highbush varieties. The second species, lowbush blueberry, also known as wild or untamed blueberry. These are principally harvested in the state of Maine and the eastern and central provinces of Canada. Rabbit eye and half-high blueberry are not as predominant in cultivations as other two species. However, some biological characteristics make them desirable in the regions where high bush and low bush do not grow well. Though native to North America, blueberries are now grown on six continents around the world. The United States, Canada, and Poland are the top three blueberry-producing countries in the world. The blueberry production in Chile and Argentina are also important because they are the main countries for importing blueberry during the off-season in the United States. In North Carolina, blueberry production areas are primarily located in the eastern part of the state with the highest concentration of production in the two counties, Bladen County and Payne County, which are marked in dark blue color. In North Carolina, two blueberry species are grown. For commercial production, farmers use highbush blueberry, particularly southern highbush varieties. Rabbit eye is also grown here, but is primarily used by homeowners. Blueberry production in the United States has seen largely steady growth for the past decade. In this figure, the purple bar represents blueberry production in the United States, while the blue bars show the volume of imported blueberries. The yellow line on the top is the demand of blueberries in the United States. As shown here, the demand of blueberry has grown exponentially for the past few years. In year 2000, a publication pointed the health benefits of blueberry consumption, and demands increased nearly every year thereafter. Today, blueberry is recognized as a superfood because of its numerous health-promoting properties. Blueberry is low in calories, high dietary fiber, and vitamin C. In addition, they are also high in vitamin K and manganese. The known benefits of consuming blueberry include promoting insulin response, reducing the risk of cancer, promoting cardiovascular health, and also improving brain health. Another well-known health-promoting factor of blueberry is its high antioxidant content, possibly a tribute to the high concentration of anthocyanins. Anthocyanins are the compounds that are responsible for red, blue, and purple color in plants. The color of blueberry is reflected by the composition and contents of different types of anthocyanins. In nature, there are six anthocyanins, and five of them can be found in blueberry. The one that are not found in blueberry, pelargonidine, is responsible for orange-red color. It is pretty amazing that blueberry, with a relatively small fruit size, can have such a high concentration of anthocyanins. Although the measurement methods and criteria vary between laboratories, blueberry has consistently shown a high concentration of anthocyanins. a publication really last year from research conducted at North Carolina State University, reported a range of 74 to 537 milligram per 100 grams of blueberry in the total anthocyanin concentration observed from more than 1,300 wild and cultivated commercial blueberry. Generally, it has been observed in research that fruits of low bush blueberry contain higher levels of anthocyanin than high bush or rabbit eye blueberry. Anthocyanin consumption can improve many different areas of human health. Research suggests that anthocyanin have the potential to lower cancer risk, improve eyesight, lower the risk of diabetes onset, offer neuroprotective benefits, and provide anti-inflammatory relief. Here is a simple illustration of anthocyanin biosynthesis pathway. The biosynthetic pathway of anthocyanin involves a generalized flavonoid pathway and a specific anthocyanin pathway. The anthocyanin and flavonoid biosynthetic pathway has been well established in a number of crops, including maize, snapdragon, petunia, and grape. From the knowledge established from these plants, a large number of structural and regulatory genes have been identified in other plant species. However, since there has not much similar research done on blueberry, identifying this gene in blueberry is an important area of study in the future. There are several reasons for studying blueberry genome. First, blueberry is a perennial woody plant. It takes at least 3 years for a seedling to flower and fruit. Also, blueberry has strong inbreeding depression, which is due to self-incompatibility, meaning it is difficult or impossible to create a self-inbred line, which is desirable to strengthen a specific gene or trait of interest. For self-incompatibility plants, the pollen must come from the plant that is a different variety, not the same plant and not even a different plant of the same variety. For successful fertilization, that will result in fruit production. This means, in the field, two or more compatible varieties must be planted together, usually in neighboring rows, to achieve commercial fruit production. In addition, blueberry has a relatively complex ploidy level. Ploidy level indicates how many sets of chromosomes an organism has. In this situation, the gene may have several copies, so it's harder for scientists to determine which one is the one they want, or to completely knock out the genes they don't want to express. However, multiple ploidy level is an important evolutionary force for plants. Generally, polyploids are more vigorous than their diploid progenies and are known to show new phenotype variation. The ploidy level of blueberry can vary, including diploid, tetraploid, and hexaploid within different blueberry species. Also of note is that blueberry has a strong triploid block, which means that when crossing different blueberry species, such as a diploid and tetraploid, the cross will either be unsuccessful or the progeny will die easily. So, it is difficult to observe some phenotypes in early stage of blueberry growth. For example, if you're breeding for a fruit quality trait, then there is likely a 3-year wait before you know whether the breeding is successful or not. Marker assist selection may be beneficial in blueberry breeding programs, which have all the difficulty mentioned above. Marker assist selection targets variation at the DNA level, which remain the same no matter what the size or age of the seedling. This technology will allow screening in the early stage of seedling production to see if a gene of a specific trait are present or not. If the desirable trait is present, then grower or breeder may decide to continue growing this plant or use it for a future breeding program. Here is a simple comparison of a traditional breeding and marker assist selection. In traditional breeding, desired traits are identified in the separated individuals of the same species, which are then bred to combine those traits in the new hybrid variety. While in marker assist selection, when the gene for a trait are not specifically known, targeting a DNA marker near them, can speed out the breeding. It identifies plants with a trait even before it matures. Unlike genetic engineering, marker-assist selection breeding targets the genes that already exist in the species, using the biotechnology to increase or decrease the expression, instead of introducing genes from the other species. By using marker-assist selection, the breeding process can be accelerated, especially for perennial crops. And by investigating genes at the DNA level, some recessive phenotypes can also be targeted, such as resistance to disease and insects, fruit quality, flavor, and so on. In addition, marker-assist selection uses genes that already exist in the plant, so there is no biosafety issues triggered by introducing genes from other species. Overall, marker-assist selection can reduce failed, time, labor inputs, ultimately save time and money a lot. Currently, there are many new technologies that can be applied into plant breeding programs. These technologies include a better understanding of molecular genetics, genomic sequencing, and bioinformatics, which enable scientists to process large amounts of data. North Carolina State University is one of the several universities and institutes studying the blueberry genome in the United States. The Blueberry Genome Project started in 2009, using different sequencing technology. The ultimate goal of this project is to complete the blueberry genome and enable other researchers and scientists to look in more detail for blueberry genome study. The study of blueberry genomic is ongoing. More improvement and targeted breeding can be expected in the future to address issues including increased nutrition content, disease resistance, soil adaptation, and fruit quality. While blueberry breeding takes time, these advanced genomic tools assist in achieving the ultimate goal of developing a better blueberry that meets growers' needs and offers consumers health benefits. Thank you for listening. If you have any question, feel free to contact me at the following email address. Thank you.